But first up this morning, convicted felon and former President Donald Trump has this morning shredded the New York legal system that yesterday found him guilty of a historic 34 charges. It comes as his legal team now prepares to appeal the verdict. Let's go live to US Bureau Chief David Woywood, who's in New York for us. Dave, morning to you. Donald Trump, it appears, still furious with this ruling, perhaps not surprising.
Yeah, good morning, Mon. Donald Trump is still seething at the moment. That much is clear. Look, he has spent his first full night inside his Manhattan penthouse apartment, a convicted criminal, and then he has started today with what he has called a press conference in the foyer of his Manhattan Trump Towers today. Although he wasn't taking any questions, he has gone on something of a rant today. Look, it was pretty hard to follow through some of it, and it was almost incoherent at other times, but essentially he has really stepped up those verbal attacks here on everyone involved in this case that yesterday found him guilty of those 34 felony counts. He has stepped up those attacks on the US President Joe Biden, the judge involved in this case. He has called him the devil, and he has even said that America is now a fascist country, and perhaps this is fueling part of Donald Trump's rage. These are the newspapers today right across the country. Every broadsheet and every tabloid has Donald Trump's photo with that headline just screaming back, guilty. Look, the former president, he knows that he is in the spotlight right now, and he is trying to really leverage this moment for maximum political effect.
This is a case where if they can do this to me, they can do this to anyone. These are bad people. These are, in many cases, I believe, sick people. It was a rigged trial. We wanted a venue change where we could have a fair trial. We didn't get it. We wanted a judge change. We wanted a judge that wasn't conflicted. And obviously, he didn't do that. So we're going to be appealing this scam. We're going to be appealing it on many different things. He wouldn't allow us to have witnesses. He wouldn't allow us to talk. He wouldn't allow us to do anything. The judge was a tyrant.
Yes, that appeals process now underway from Team Trump. Look, in addition to the president actually hitting the airwaves there, a number of his supporters have been as well. They have been rushing to his side, really a full court press on the cable news networks today. We've also heard from a number of his family members, his two sons, Eric and Don Jr., his daughter-in-law, Lara, as well. In fact, she's the co-chair of the Republican National Committee, and she's put out this little video of Donald Trump today in his penthouse apartment with his two grandchildren. But quite tellingly, we're still yet to hear from his wife, Melania Trump. She is still yet to offer any form of public support for her husband ever since this verdict was handed down in this porn star hush money trial. But we have heard from the current US President Joe Biden today. Look, he has said Donald Trump was afforded every single effort by the American legal system here during this process. He now has that right to appeal this, but he should now abide by this ruling.
The American principle that no one is above the law was reaffirmed. Donald Trump was given every opportunity to defend himself. Now he'll be given the opportunity, as he should, to appeal that decision just like everyone else has that opportunity. That's how the American system of justice works.
And just lastly, guys, some pretty interesting figures since that verdict was actually handed down yesterday. How's this? Google searches for Donald Trump have skyrocketed. They have absolutely exploded more than 3,000%. And the Trump camp is now claiming as well that they have raked in more than $52 million in donations.